Hi, welcome to the Flying Squirrel. I'm in the middle of the farm in Polybeta at Coog, where we strive towards making Flying Squirrel coffee truly artisanal. There are primarily three different types of coffee, or rather species: Arabica, Robusta, and Liberica. So I'm going to take you through an Arabica plant. Arabica plants are generally grown at an altitude of 3,500 feet above sea level. They are a lot fragile, so how do we protect them? So we grow a lot of shade trees and give them a microclimatic condition which protects them from different types of pests, etc. So Arabica plant generally grows to a height of about 4 feet, like you would see, and has a diameter of about 3.5 to 4 feet. The nodes are slightly closer and their leaves are slightly slender. The stem are quite fragile, which needs a lot of attention right through the year. The harvesting season is generally from the month of November to January. So that's when the processing really goes on. Coming to the flavor profile of the Arabica, Arabicas are a lot fruitier. They have a lot of sugar buildup. That's why it's a lot sweeter. Now, to maintain that, we have the roasting a slightly lighter to give in all the taste profiles that an Arabica could give out. Now, Arabicas are slightly more aromatic and they have less body and more acidity. When I say acidity, it is just the brightness of the cup, which gives you different types of flavor, which all depends on the kind of processing that we take at the farm. So here we are at the Robusta patch at the farm. Like the name says, Robustas are a lot robust. They're more hardier. They're grown at an altitude of about 3,500 feet and below sea level. They demand a little bit of shade, so it's generally shade grown, but they are sun lovers. Like you can see the plant, they're rod structured. They grow to a height of about 7 to 8 feet. They go to a width of about 7 to 8 feet as well in dia. Nodes are slightly further apart. The fruit cluster holds about 35 to 45 fruit. Taste profile also changes considerably compared to an Arabica. They are slightly low on aroma. They are high on body, which gives you a nice mouth feel when you have your cup. It's slightly low on acidity. And the caffeine content in Robusta is very interesting. It's got slightly higher as compared to an Arabica at about 2 to 2.5%. The bitterness, which is very interesting in a Robusta, is slightly higher, where the chlorogenic acid is at about 10%. The harvesting in coffee is in the time between January to March. So that's when the processing, the interesting profiles in a coffee is shown out, where we get, considering the end note, we do the processing on the farm. Now that you know the difference between Arabica and Robusta, each of them have a completely different plant structure and a different taste profile.